Streams in the Desert. Volume 1. By Elizabeth Cowman. April 26. I even reckon all things as pure loss because of the priceless privilege of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord. Philippians 3:8, Weymouth. Shining is always costly. Light comes only at the cost of that which produces it. An unfit candle does no shining. Burning must come before shining. We cannot be of great use to others without cost to ourselves. Burning suggests suffering. We shrink from pain. We are apt to feel that we are doing the greatest good in the world when we are strong and able for active duty, and when the heart and hands are full of kindly service. When we are called aside and can only suffer when we are sick, when we are consumed with pain, when all our activities have been dropped, we feel that we are no longer of use, that we are not doing anything. But if we are patient and submissive, it is almost certain that we are a greater blessing to the world in our time of suffering and pain than we were in the days when we thought we were doing the most of our work. We are burning now, and shining because we are burning. Evening thoughts. The glory of tomorrow is rooted in the drudgery of today. Many want the glory without the cross, the shining without the burning, but crucifixion comes before coronation. Have you heard the tale of the aloe plant? Away in the sunny clime? By humble growth of 100 years. It reaches its blooming time. And then a wondrous bud at its crown. Breaks into 1,000 flowers. This floral queen, in its blooming scene, is the pride of the tropical bowers. But the plant to the flower is sacrifice. For it blooms but once, and it dies. Have you further heard of the aloe plant? That grows in the sunny clime. How every one of its 1,000 flowers, as they drop in the blooming time, is an infant plant that fastens its roots in the place where it falls on the ground. And as fast as they drop from the dying stem, grow lively and lovely around. By dying, it liveth 1,000-fold. In the young that spring from the death of the old. Have you heard the tale of the pelican? The Arab's gimel el bear. That lives in the African solitudes. Where the birds that live lonely are. Have you heard how it loves its tender young? And cares and toils for their good. It brings them water from mountains far. And fishes the seas for their food. In famine it feeds them what love can devise. The blood of its bosom and, feeding them, dies. Have you heard this tale, the best of them all? The tale of the holy and true. He dies, but his life, in untold souls, lives on in the world anew. His seed prevails, and is filling the earth. As the stars fill the sky above, he taught us to yield up the love of life. For the sake of the life of love, his death is our life, his loss is our gain. The joy for the tear, the peace for the pain. By selected.